The June 2020 product update for Fusion 360 has seen the release of a brand new root surface feature. To start this feature, activate the Surface tab, go to Create, Root. You can think of this tool as a quick way of creating a flange-type surface by using existing edges of solid bodies, surface bodies, or sketch entities. Before the introduction of the root surface feature, such a feature would have been created by drawing a sketch that represents the cross-section and sweeping it across a path, or creating two sketch profiles on different planes and creating a loft between them. It can also be created by the Extrude surface feature, but more on that later. The sweep and loft features can be intimidating for new users. The root surface feature provides a quick and intuitive alternative. However, do take note that it is restricted to a straight line profile. Whenever you take a cross-section of a root surface, you will see that the cross-section is always a straight line. To create more complex shapes, you will still need to revert to using the sweep and loft features. The root surface feature can be applied on sketches, surface bodies, or solid bodies. Let's try creating a root surface using this sketch. With the chain selection option checked, you can select all four edges of the rectangle at the same time. Next, we need to choose a direction. Click on the select box. If we pick on the y-axis and drag on the arrow, the extrude would be parallel to this axis. Let's remove this selection. We can also pick on a plane. Let's pick on the top plane. By default, the extrude would happen in a direction normal to the selected plane. We can also select edges and planes of existing solid bodies. The extrude distance can be changed by entering a value in the distance field or dragging on the arrow. We can choose to vary the angle of the extrude by changing the value in the angle dimension field or turning the wheel in the graphics area. If we delete the selected profiles and uncheck the chain selection option, we can select individual edges. Confirming the feature, we'll add a new surface body to the bodies folder. The same workflow applies to surface bodies. For solid bodies, when you select an edge, you are presented with an alternate faces option. This is because every edge of a solid body is shared between two surfaces. At the point of selection, Fusion makes a guess as to which surface you are referencing for the direction. To switch to the other face, click on the alternate face option. So that wraps up the overview of the root surface feature. Next, I will be comparing the root surface feature to the extrude surface and extend surface features. If you are not interested in this comparison, feel free to use the timestamp below to jump ahead to the application section. So how does the root surface feature compare to the extrude surface feature? Well, the extrude surface feature can also work on sketches, surfaces, and existing solid bodies. It also has a chaining option for selection. There is also an option to adjust the angle known as the taper angle here. Here is where the difference comes in. For extrude, the range is limited to 90 degrees in either the positive or negative direction. To get the other 180 degrees of motion, you would have to flip the extrusion direction. In the root surface feature, you are allowed the full range of 360 degrees. Another important difference is that the root surface can be performed on a chain of edges bordering a non-planar face, while the extrude feature cannot. Another close cousin to the root surface feature is the extend feature. So how does this compare to the root surface feature? The extend feature can only be used on surfaces. It cannot be used on sketches or solid bodies. In terms of direction, the extend feature is limited to three types: natural, perpendicular, or tangent. You are not free to adjust the angle. Also, no new bodies are created by the extend feature. Upon confirmation, the extended surface is automatically stitched to the existing surface. Here are some interesting applications of the root surface feature. You can create interesting vessel-like structures by building root surfaces upon one another. After the root surfaces are created, we would have a list of surface bodies in the bodies folder. In order to combine them into one single surface body, go to Modify, Stitch. Select all the surfaces and stitch them into one single surface body. At this point, you can go to Create, Thicken, and add a wall thickness to the whole surface. Another useful application is to leverage on existing edges of solid bodies to create a surface for cutting. For example, we have a solid body consisting of a cone on top of a cuboid. I want to create a root surface using this circular edge to cut away material from the cuboid. Start the root surface feature, select the edge, adjust the distance and angle. Upon confirmation, a new surface body is formed. Let's hide the solid body to take a look. Go to Modify, Split Body. Select the solid body as a body to split. Select the surface as a splitting tool. In this case, we need to uncheck the Extend Splitting Tool option so that the cutting surface does not extend into the cone. Confirm the feature and hide the unwanted split body. We can also use a replace face function to achieve the same effect. Activate the solid tab. Go to Modify, Replace Face. For source faces, select the original top surface of the cuboid. For target faces, select the root surface. Unhide the root surface to see the newly created solid.